Hey folks, this is Best in Slot, and in this quick little video, we're going to take a look at a really cool exhibit design idea that's been popping up all over the subreddit and Discords and stuff like that over the past couple of weeks. And it does rely on a mod, I'm afraid, so this is PC users only, and again, only people who are comfortable with mods. And because it's a mod, I am going to throw in my disclaimer that this could, and possibly will, break your game at some point, especially when the game updates in just a week or so's time. It's just something to keep in mind, it's something cool to showcase, because it lets us do something I think a lot of us wanted to see. And that is, as you can kind of tell, it lets us combine our terrestrial dinosaur habitats and our pterosaur habitats. And of course, the mod to do this with, I'll link it down below, is Cryodenics Free Build Mod, and that essentially gets rid of your building constraints. As you can see, if I want to build fences like so, I can build fences like so. If I want to put a lagoon or an aviary on top of those fences, I can do just that. It looks super weird, but we can do it. And what that means we can do, basically I built this aviary, and then if we hop into this map view here, you'll see there's a fence all the way around it, and that let me attach the hatchery on and stuff like that, but it also lets me keep the dinosaurs inside. So let's hop into letterbox, because it looks dramatic, and let's check it out. I think it looks really cool, by the way. I just want to put this out there. First of all, just having the dinosaurs in this environment with the glass roof in this kind of like self-contained biodome, I think looks really cool. And but then having the dinosaurs and the pterosaurs living together like this is even better. That looks really good to me. I'm really impressed with how well this works out. And the dinosaurs are properly contained, and they're not going to go anywhere. You know, they're not moving from this point. And everyone's kind of getting on well. Obviously, I've stuck to herbivores, turned off comfort. No one's going to eat anyone, hopefully. The Geosternbergia and the Dimorphodon will generally leave each other alone if it's they're more than happy. And yeah, I mean, just to start off, I think this is a really cool idea. It works really well. Actually, there's one thing I'd like to do. It'll be down the line, but as a sandbox park, if you've been paying attention to the Camp Cretaceous, we know we've got this biodome thing coming along the way. What if we did a biodome kind of park with like different aviary domes filled with different creatures? You could have like a Cretaceous dome and a Triassic dome and stuff like that. I think that's a really cool idea. But yeah, not much else to say about this specifically. I think it looks really good. I think it needs more pterosaurs to really highlight the point. I think they're all sitting down somewhere, actually. Oh, there we go. Hello, Geo. But isn't it beautiful? I think it looks spectacular. I really do. So shout out to Cryodenic for the mod, which lets us do this. I'm stuck inside a hatchery. I am now egg. And yeah, definitely go check out the mod if you want to. I mean, there's a few days now till the update. You could download it, play around with it for a little bit, and then just delete it. You know, it's very easy to do so. But I will always say that mods carry a bit of a risk, and I have to make sure I mention that, because otherwise the world will shout at me. Now, this is all well and good. This is cool. However, there is something else I would like to try, and that is, how well does this work? And I can't imagine very well, but how well would this work if we did the same in a lagoon? Should we go test it out? Let's go test it out. I'm going to do a time lapse for this one. Actually, you know what? You know, I've got instant build on. You guys can join me. So let's just build a relatively small lagoon shape like that. Right. And I'll show you what I did with the other. So you just kind of... Oh, it even latches on for some reason. Interesting. Okay. And we're just going to drag the fence along. Doesn't have to be the neatest thing in the world. It's science. Science is always messy initially. He says, trying desperately to get that to work. That'll bloody do. Right. So, let's get ourselves a lagoon hatchery. Okay, you're being very strange. Is that strange? No, that's right. That's how it should be. It just looked bizarre to me. And can we get ourselves a... Yeah, okay. So there's our floating regular hatchery. There you go. Let's see. Yeah, the trees actually come all the way down. Interesting. Okay, cool. Now we just need to join these together via the path tool. It's got a big chunky path. Why not? Because it looks super weird when you do it half and half. And we need to join this together. Okay, now obviously we need a marine creature. Let's stick a Mosasaurus in there. I'm a little worried that I still have mods installed from the other day, but I don't think I do. Okay. Pop the Mosasaurus out. Right, but this is obviously the important thing. How is this going to happen? What do you want to release? What am I finding? Mutaborosaurus. Great dinosaur. Looks fantastic in Evolution 2. Let's pop all four of those out. I'm a little weirdly apprehensive in a weird way. Mosasaurus is fine, just living its best life. I just thought of another idea. We'll come to that in a second. Let's release these mutters, see what happens. Okay. That doesn't work. Okay, but all hope is not lost. We're going to build a... so many buildings because of these bloody mods. Where's the operations thing? Response facility, there we go. We're going to build a response facility. And we're going to... you can actually do this, I believe. Yeah, we're going to tranquilize these mutters. And see if we can transfer them from the hatchery into the pit, essentially. Because it is an exhibit, right? So clearly the hatchery is not working. No longer called the John Hammond Incubation Center or whatever. The hatchery is clearly not working. Oh, never mind. Hello. I don't know what happened, but... that might... honestly, that could have been unrelated. There is a bit of a bug where things don't pop out of the hatchery. So is this how it's going to look? Is it just going to be Jesus Mutaborosaurus?
It is possible for a dinosaur to be both elegant and awkward at the same time. Then the Mutaborosaurus takes the prize.
It's pretty cool that they float, gotta say. I can't deliver there, though. Can I deliver into there? Can't deliver there either, okay. Okay, so at least we found out what happens. They don't seem able to move any further. clearly this is not something you should be doing. But it's cool to know that it works, you know? Okay, what if we... this is a little crazy. What if we do all three? What if I put an aviary over the top, like so? And then we're going to stick our aviary hatchery on there. The wheels of science must not stop turning, ladies and gentlemen. If there's something strange we can do, we shall do it. Let's get... what has a big popular... let's just go for Cyrodactylus. I'm in a Cyrodactylus kind of mood. You know what I mean. Everyone feels like that now and again. I mean, this should work fine in theory. I think it would be better if the lagoon was bigger than the...
honestly, the flying animals concern me the most from a security standpoint. We can round up escaped land animals, but when they take to the sky, all bets are off. This is the Cyrodactylus, and we need to make sure it stays confined to the aviary. The only known species of this animal before today was named after the Latin name for frightful. That should tell you something.
Where are they? Are they in the oh god, they're in the water. Okay, I've invented a whole new species. It's the aquatic pterosaur. Cyrodactylus, the wetadactylus, the underwater Cyrodactylus. Amazing. Okay. I mean, that's kind of what I thought. I, clearly, they're treating the bottom of the lagoon as the bottom of the aviary, and they're flying in a height relative to it as they would, kind of thing. It's pretty cool. Unfortunately, I kind of thought that's what the Mutaborosauruses would do. They're being very weird. So the last thing I want to try, then, if we grab our lagoon again and we put it over the top of this, what will happen? Who knows? Wait, I shouldn't do this. Because I need to take a good screenshot. Oh. Yeah. Okay. So what's happening? Yep, that's... yeah, so the lagoon does not play that nicely with everyone else. Nothing down here, right? No, unfortunately not. It would have been cool if the dinosaurs... the pterosaurs do it. They instantly sink to the bottom. I see them all doing it. But the dinosaurs, they float, essentially. But... what you could do, though, because actually, I think that looks really cool. If you ignore the rocks and the dinosaurs and stuff, that actually looks really cool inside the aviary with the dinosaurs at the edge. You could put a little fence. Which is the littlest fence? They're all ginormous. But you could put a fence, like, along here. And hopefully, I mean, I think there's a fence mod out there, so we could get, like, smaller fences. But you put a fence along like that, and you could have the lagoon inside here and keep the dinosaurs out of it. Your pterosaurs would go for a swim immediately, I guess they clearly love to do, but... yeah, I don't know, we can build some really funky stuff. funky. So we'll be doing some relatively normal sandbox builds initially. In terms of new species and stuff, I'm going to stay away from that. But to be honest, things like Cryodenic's free build mod and the sandbox expansion mods and stuff like that, I think are super high value. They just give you more creative control, and I think that's, generally speaking, a very good thing. We'll hold off on the biodome idea, but I don't want anyone else to steal it. Oh, hello. Matabora doing your thing. So basically, I think that might be the second build we do. I just think we could do some really cool things using this as a base idea. But let me know what you think in the comment section down below. And that is about it from... Oh, what happens if we delete this? Does it just go back to normal? I feel bad for the pterosaurs who are inside there already. It's also very hard to delete. Bit over there. You can make like little pools and stuff like that, and all you have to do is put a fence around them. Actually, the dinosaurs might not walk past the lagoon edge anyway. You might not even need a fence in the first place, and everything just goes back to normal. Beautiful stuff. Thank you very much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Let me know what you think about this in the comment section down below. Throw me a like if you enjoy the idea and the craziness. I'll see you folks then. Cheers much as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.